Good morning, Grade 8 Bromind. I am Mrs. Maria Lourdes G. Escandalio. How's your week 1 to week 5? Hope you are done with your activity sheets because we'll now proceed to week 6. But before we proceed, I want you to stay put and focus on our lesson for the day. Please take note of the following while you are listening to our video. Get your pen and your paper and take down notes as the lesson is presented. Also, be ready to message any inquiry or further clarification regarding the lesson. So, are you ready? Oh, I know that you are all saying yes. To begin with, we'll have a short prayer.
Let us pray. Our loving and generous God, we praise and thank you for the bountiful blessings you have given us. We are sorry for the times we have failed you. We humbly ask for your forgiveness. Help us stay focused on our studies. When learning becomes difficult, grant us the gifts of courage and enthusiasm. Grant us the grace to use our knowledge in making a difference to the lives of the people around us. All this we pray in your mighty name. Amen.
Please take a look at these short slides. Can you describe what is in the picture? Well, your answers might be the same as mine. Very good. So, is there anything that you can do to fix or clean these messy items? Going to wash it to make it clean. Any idea regarding our lesson for today? Yes, you are correct if you say cleaning and disinfection. Our tasks for today are the following. So, the first part of our lesson are the essential kitchen cleaning materials with their uses. As we watch the presentation, I want you to understand that using proper tools in cleaning kitchen tools helps maintain its good quality. You can also apply this at home, in your own kitchen, in order to maintain the clean and hygienic way of working. Likewise, you can integrate this lesson, and we had also learned this in our previous quarter, the cookery, wherein we deal with the different agents in cleaning cooking utensils and equipment as well. And also, you can apply this lesson in your science class, wherein you learn about the different content of chemicals that are present in the solution or agents used in cleaning. So guys, let us continue and watch this. essential cleaning materials and their uses. Let us see, how do we apply this if we are going to clean our cooking or baking tools as well as the kitchen premises itself? Please stay put as I gave you the steps in cleaning and sanitizing or disinfecting kitchen tools. Roll video. Furthermore, this lesson is very timely to our situation nowadays. Since we are all suffering this pandemic, we must always observe cleanliness and sanitation, not only in our kitchen, but all throughout in order to preserve good health and proper hygiene. Let us keep our home safe and clean in order to preserve good health. I will end my presentation with this video. If possible, let us learn to adapt this habit at home.
Now that you know how to avoid cross-contamination, let's take a closer look at cleaning and sanitizing in part 5. Some crucial points in this segment include the difference between cleaning and sanitizing and why it's important, washing dishes by hand and using a commercial dishwasher, cleaning and sanitizing are not the same. Cleaning uses soap and water to remove dirt and food from surfaces, while sanitizing uses chemicals or heat to kill germs. Remember that surfaces that look clean may still have germs that you cannot see. Sanitizing reduces these germs to safer levels. Food contact surfaces should be washed, rinsed, and sanitized after each use to remove germs that can cause illness. Chemical sanitizers must be mixed following the label's directions, and soap should never be added to sanitizers. Use test strips to make sure the sanitizer is not too strong or too weak. Change the sanitizing solution often because grease, dirt, and food particles make the sanitizer less effective. Store wiping cloths in clean sanitizer. If you're washing dishes by hand, all dishes and food contact surfaces must be washed, rinsed, and sanitized between uses. The procedure for washing dishes by hand is as follows. First, clean and sanitize the sink. Then, scrape leftover food into the garbage. Wash dishes in hot, soapy water in the first sink and rinse dishes with clean hot water in the second sink. Sanitize by soaking the dishes in the third sink filled with warm water and an approved sanitizer. Always air dry dishes. Towels can breed bacteria if left wet. You may have a mechanical dishwasher that will wash, rinse, and sanitize the dishes. You need to know that the dishes are reaching correct temperatures for sanitization. So temperature gauges and sanitizer levels must be monitored. If you have any questions, speak with your person in charge about proper dishwasher operations. Many of the same basic practices for dishwasher use at home apply to commercial dishwashers, yet don't be fooled, the stakes are high to get this right. To get the cleanest dishes, start by scraping leftover food from the dishes, then stack dishes in dish racks. Do not stack dishes on top of each other, as this will not allow water to circulate properly. To keep them from filling with water and dirt, glasses, cups, and bowls should be turned upside down in the dishwasher. Plates and flatware should be stood up edgewise. Dishes should be allowed to air dry for 1 to 2 minutes before removing from racks. Just like towel drying is not acceptable for hand washing, it's also not used for dishwashing. Towel drying could contaminate the dishes. Inspect all items coming out of the dishwasher. Are there spots or stains? Are all dishes and flatware clean and free of food? No soap should remain on any dishes. Chipped or cracked dishware must be removed from service. After dishes are clean and dry, handle and store them correctly to minimize possible contamination. Don't touch the surface of any glasses or plates that a guest's mouth will touch. Cups, bowls, pots, pans, etc. must be stored upside down. Handle silverware and other utensils by the handles only. Always store kitchen utensils at least 6 inches off the floor in clean, dry areas. Here are the facts on cleaning and sanitizing. Cleaning and sanitizing are different. Cleaning uses soap and water, while sanitizing uses chemicals or heat to kill germs. Surfaces that look clean can still have germs. Sanitizing reduces these germs to safer levels. Food contact surfaces should be washed, rinsed, and sanitized between each use. Follow the label directions on all sanitizers. Never add soap to sanitizer. If washing dishes by hand, use the three-sink method to wash, rinse, and sanitize dishes. Store bowls upside down and store utensils and dishes at least 6 inches off the ground. Never touch a part of a dish or utensil that a guest's mouth might touch.